Hello everyone and welcome to the workshop. Today we're going to be taking a look at AI capabilities of a Raspberry Pi. And I know, you're probably rolling your eyes and thinking, oh no, another useless video about AI. I know there has been a lot of hype around AI and my intent in this video is to show you what is actually possible with a Raspberry Pi, if anything. I'll also compare the Raspberry Pi 5 with its main AI competitor, an SBC with the RK3588 chip on it. Unlike the Raspberry Pi, the RISC V5C has a built-in neural processing unit, or NPU, that helps with AI tasks. This video is the first video in a two-part series. In this first video, I'll be covering large language models, or LLMs, and in a later video, I'll cover computer vision. Let me sidetrack a little bit and tell you how I started digging into the Raspberry Pi's AI features. I was pretty excited to try out GitHub Copilot for free when it was made available to the general public at the end of 2024 and beginning of 25. Unfortunately though, I hit GitHub Copilot's monthly quota for code suggestions just a couple weeks after starting to use it. Granted, I was coding almost daily for 2 to 3 hours a day while I was working on a new website that I hope to launch later this year. I was just getting used to GitHub Copilot, adjusting the settings, and starting to understand when I should accept the coding suggestions and when I shouldn't. And then I got hit with the monthly cap. To make things worse, the day my monthly cap was supposed to roll over, GitHub Copilot just bugged out and put me in AI jail for another month. This issue is currently fixed for me, but it set me on a quest to find out a fully local alternative to GitHub Copilot. I didn't want to depend on a service that can just lock me out for whatever reason. After a couple exchanges on Blue Sky with code monkey Phil Howard, aka Gadgetoid, I decided to give the Raspberry Pi 5 a chance as my own coding assistant. Is a Raspberry Pi a viable GitHub Copilot replacement? Are there better options out there? Let's find out. For this project in particular, a Raspberry Pi 5 is highly recommended. Running an LLM on the Raspberry Pi is a very demanding task. The Pi 5 or the Pi 500 are possibly the only Raspberry Pi computers that can handle large language models. Yes, it is possible to run an LLM on a Pi 4, but I'm talking about practical terms here. To make it usable, you really need the Pi 5. The easiest way to run a large language model locally on a Pi 5 is to install Ollama, which is very simple to do on any computer, really. Be it a Mac, Windows, or a Linux machine like a Raspberry Pi. I just grabbed the install script from their website and I was up and running in a few minutes. Well, more or less. I still had to download the models themselves, and that can take a little while since models can be quite large. So use a hardwired Ethernet connection for sure. Qwen 2.5 Coder seems to be the most recommended code assistant model out there, so that's the one I downloaded first. I was feeling pretty ambitious and I downloaded the 7 billion parameter model, but I quickly realized that was not going to work on the Raspberry Pi 5. I mean, it ran, but it was painfully slow. Models with more parameters are able to provide better and more useful suggestions, but they're also heavier to run. So I moved to trying the 3 billion and the 1.5 billion parameter models. Second sidetrack of the video, I found out the hard way that using a micro SD card for the OS is not a good option to run LLMs on the Raspberry Pi. The OS will have to load the model files from disk and a micro SD card can be pretty slow. I saw much better performance when I was using NVMe drive through PCIe. I still had to tweak a lot of settings that I'll cover later in the video, but PCIe NVMe is definitely the way to go. And if you're doing this, make sure you have adequate cooling. When Ollama is doing its thing, it will max out all CPU cores and your Pi will get very hot very quickly. Now that Ollama is running and I have a model loaded, I can ask for coding suggestions directly from the terminal. But that's not very useful, and that's not even close to the same experience that tools like ChatGPT and GitHub Copilot provide. So that's where Open Web UI comes in. This is an open source front end for Ollama that provides a more refined chat experience. Copying and pasting directly from the terminal is not ideal, but copying and pasting from Open Web UI works like you would expect for a modern interface. It even allows you to upload documents to use it as context for your prompts, something not easily done through the terminal. So Open Web UI is like having your own ChatGPT, but what about coding assistance directly in VS Code like GitHub Copilot is able to offer? Ollama on its own does not integrate with VS Code or any other IDE. To get VS Code to talk to my shiny new coding assistant, I had to install Continue plugin for VS Code. Continue will send the relevant information to Ollama and will retrieve the coding suggestions and will format it nicely directly in the code editor. Continue plugin is also available on JetBrains IDEs like PyCharm, which I've been using lately. The documentation for the Continue plugin is not great, and it took me quite a bit of searching and troubleshooting to even get it to connect to my Ollama instance on my Raspberry Pi. And once it did connect, it was very slow. They list the settings you can tweak, but they don't explain when you should tweak them. I was pretty discouraged when I got to this point, but I wasn't going to give up just yet. And yep, I was still locked out of GitHub Copilot anyway. The thing with LLMs is that they are designed to run on high-end equipment with modern GPUs, which, you know, it's not something the Raspberry Pi 5 is equipped with. You have to bring the settings down quite a bit to make it more useful on the limited hardware like a Raspberry Pi 5. So it's a balance between providing useful code suggestions and not having to wait like a full minute for it to come up with something as simple as a variable name, because, you know, I could have just typed that. On the other hand though, if you turn the settings too low, like using a very small model or limiting the amount of context they sent to Ollama, the suggestions are going to be super quick, but they're going to be pretty much garbage. Not very helpful as a coding assistant. So I'm sorry to inform that Ollama on the Raspberry Pi 5 is not really useful when it comes to code completion. It's interesting that the chat experience is pretty decent, but the coding suggestions is pretty bad. I guess writing code is a lot more dynamic than just typing a prompt into the chat box. A lot of you might be thinking, but hey, can't you just put one of those new AI hats on the Raspberry Pi 5 and will be awesome? Actually, not really. Like I have covered in the previous video, the Raspberry Pi 5 AI hat is not designed to handle LLMs. They're only helpful if you're doing computer vision processing on your Pi 5, which we'll be taking a look in the next video in this series. There has been news that Halo, the same company that makes the chips for the AI hats, is working on NPU targeted specifically for LLMs. So it will be interesting to see how much more capable the Pi 5 would be with one of these LLM NPUs. Now that we saw how the Raspberry Pi 5 performs as a code assistant, how does it compare to a single board computer that has an NPU on board? So I put my ROG 5C to the test. In one of my previous videos, I mentioned how much of a pain it was to get an LLM running on the ROG 5C. But things have improved a lot since then because of the growing community of ROG chip users. Whereas just a few months ago, I had to use an x86 computer to convert the LLM model to the correct format, now I can just go to Hugging Face and download an already converted model and ready to use. There is also a Gradio server script that works with the ROG chip LLM format. This interface doesn't have the same bells and whistles as the OpenUI interface for the Pi 5, but it works just fine, as a chatbot at least. Running the same Qwen 2.5 coder model on the ROG 5C is twice as fast as on the Pi 5. I was getting around 18 to 20 tokens per second on the ROG 5C and only 8 tokens per second on the Pi 5. I was pretty excited to test ROG 5C as a code completion assistant in VS Code, but my excitement was very short-lived. Support for the ROG chip MPU is still very lackluster, and I couldn't find anything that would integrate with Continue or other VS Code plugins. It looks like a couple people are working on an Ollama compatible API for the ROG chip MPU, but nothing fully compatible for now though. So that's a bummer. Maybe I'll take a stab at creating my own API. It's not like I have any other projects just sitting on my workbench waiting to be worked on. Raspberry Pi 5 is not a drop-in replacement for GitHub Copilot or any other AI coding assistant platform. Although it was able to provide helpful suggestions sometimes, it was not able to keep up with my coding speed. Keep in mind that I'm not the fastest coder out there. I'm pretty bad, actually. The computer you're coding might be the best option to set up a coding assistant as long as you're not coding on a Raspberry Pi. I installed Ollama on my laptop and it worked pretty well. I was a bit bummed that the discrete graphic cards on my laptop is not supported by Ollama yet, but even with just CPU processing, I was running the Qwen 2.5 coder model with 1.5 billion parameters, the same one I ran on the Pi 5 and the ROG 5C, and I got up to 30 tokens per second. It did max out the 16 gigabytes of memory that I have on this laptop, and the fan was running almost nonstop, which is not a pleasant experience if you're trying to focus on a coding task. So where does this leave us? I think the prospect of having a local LLM coding assistant is very exciting. I don't want to rely on the whims of a multi-trillion dollar company to get some help with my coding projects. Unfortunately though, running an LLM still requires expensive hardware, and it will be interesting to see if how this changes with new advancements in neural processing units in the future. And keep an eye out for the second part of this video series where I'll be comparing AI computer vision capabilities of different single board computers. And with that, I'll see you in the next one.